boys and girls are here. I can see it, Anna, and you, Keith. And you too, Bridget. Welcome to you, Martha and Robert and Louis. You all look like you're ready to get inspired today. You know what inspired means, right? It means we'll get some new ideas and see where in Pappy Land they take us.
Hey, Sonny! Don't you know what time it is?
Oh, my, it's blue after two. It's time to get inspired to draw and color and sing. Now, how might we do that on a fine day like today? Do any of my friends have an idea for Pappy? Did I hear somebody say Pappy Scope? What a fantastic idea. Now, why didn't I think of that? Shall we scope out the scope together? Let's take a peek at what special Pappy Land place the Pappy Scope can take us today. Okay, girls and boys? I can always see things clearly through the Pappy Scope. Hi, Pappy. Are you excited about going to the Grand Garden of Pappy Land, everyone? You are? Well, let's get going now so we can start to have fun burning and drawing and singing and seeing whatever else happens. continue and see what happens. Okay, I'm going to draw his nose now. Oh, dear. Happy made a mistake. But that doesn't mean a mistake has to be something bad. I'm going to take this mistake and turn it into something good. Okay, let's continue. See something here. I'm going to give you a hint. See if you can think of the same thing I'm thinking of. It looks something like this. Have you guessed it yet? That's right. It's an elephant. I'll continue drawing upward. There! That's the elephant's trunk. Good. Now we're getting somewhere. Mistake isn't looking so terrible anymore. I'm going to draw an ear, a big ear, like that, and then I'm going to draw the side of the elephant's head, like that, and the bottom part of his mouth. Good. Now I'm going to put two circles right here for the elephant's eyes. This is looking very good. I thought my mistake was going to make me real sad, and I was going to be so unhappy, but now I'm real happy because my mistake is turning into a good drawing of an elephant. Let's continue. Okay, now we need two little dots inside of his eyes, just like that. Part of his chin there, underneath the trunk, and we're going to draw his body by drawing a circle all the way around like that, and stop. And just start like that, he didn't start at this point, and bring that line all the way around, and stop. Good. Now we'll draw his legs by making a straight line there and coming over, another straight line like that. Around and go back up. Good. Now let's just bring this over like that. And we'll draw his other legs. His hind legs. Those are the legs behind the front legs. Good. This is exciting. I thought this mistake was going to make me so unhappy, and yet we're drawing a fun elephant. It just goes to show you. Sometimes making a mistake can turn into something very, very good. Let's put two little dots for his nose there where he can breathe. Good. And on his legs, we're going to draw a couple toenails. One. Two. Good. And let's do the same on all of his legs here, right on his feet. Actually, here we go. One there. One there. Good. I know. Let's make the elephant drink some water, okay? His nose is reaching down into this little pool of water, and he's going to take a drink. And we'll start by making an oval, which is a long, flat, kind of round. It's kind of round, but it's flatter than really round really is. It's just an oval. It's just kind of like a circle. But you squeeze it down, and that becomes an oval. Good. Okay, are you with me? Let's draw the side of our little pool, like that. And we'll start over here, and we'll do it right there. Okay, now our pool needs bottom, doesn't it? So we'll connect it right there. Good. Boy, you never know this was a mistake. Okay, let's draw some water inside the pool. Starting right here. And we'll put some wiggly lines. Wiggly lines. Wiggly lines. Good. Do you know what a wiggly line is? Watch back. That's a wiggly line. I like to use Who the decided to spray some water in my direction.
Too bad you weren't born with yellow feathers.
Why is that?
Because then you could have ducked. Get it? Yellow feathers. Ducked. Oh, ducks have yellow feathers.
Oh, Elmer, when will I ever learn?
You can always learn from your mistakes, right?
That's right, Elmer. I always make the mistake of getting involved in your jokes. Now, will you excuse me while I follow with our friends?
Carry on, Pat. I never want to stand in the way of art.
I'm gonna start decoloring this elephant purple. Won't that be fun? I bet you haven't seen a purple elephant before. I don't know, but I'm gonna see one in Pappy's cabin. Okay. Let's see. This is purple. Let's give it a shot. Oh, no, that's not purple. Silver. Let's try this one. There we go. and see what you've done with your pictures, kids. And hold them up nice and high so we can see them. Wow! You've got some excellent coloring, everyone.
There's no mistaking what good artists the boys and girls are. Some of the drawings look different from yours, Pimpy. Does that mean they're mistakes?
Not at all. But using your own ideas is the best because that's how you can really get creative. Oh my, it's quarter to orange. It's time to put Pimpy away. But I'll be back, and I hope you'll come back to visit again. You know, it will be fun because...
Yeah, I know.
Anything can happen when you're in Pappy Land.
That's right. See you next time, girls and boys. Bye.
Did you ever want to paint? Did you ever want to draw? Did you ever want to recreate anything at all? Well, now you can in Pappy Land. That's where we are today. Where anything can happen. Cause Pappy drew it that way. Pappy, Pappy drew it. He drew Pappy Land. And you
to me, Pappy Drew It, P.O. Box 5004, Syracuse, New York, 13220.